Hi everyone, thank you so much for stopping by. Marine here for Sunny Studio. I am back today with a slimline shaker card featuring more birds. Last week they were tropical birds, well this time they are canaries, and I plan to make more types of birds in the coming weeks. So to make this shaker card, I used the second die from the Stitched Heart 2 die set and the Little Birdie stamp set, which is definitely my favorite from spring release. I created the background first. I cut an 8.5 by 3.5 inches Bristol panel and I used a cloud stencil along with tumble glass distress ink to turn this white panel into a cloudy panel. And just like the card I shared last week, I knew that the images would be pretty bright and colorful, so that's why I kept the background neutral and basic. Next, I created three windows in this cloudy panel, and to get something straight, I used my T-ruler to trace a vertical line right in the middle of the panel at 4.25 inches. I centered the heart die on that pencil line and sent the panel to my die cutting machine to create the first window. I set the die cut heart aside for later. And then, to line up the two other windows on each side, I put the die back in place on the first window. I traced a mark at the bottom below the pointy end, and I used my T-ruler again to trace a line on the left side of the panel and a line on the right side of the panel. I placed the die on the right side, just above the pencil line, and I cut the second window. And I did the same thing on the left side. I placed and taped the die above the pencil line, and I cut the last window. I quickly erased the pencil lines, I cut a yellow card base, and then I used my three window panel as a guide to stick the three die cut hearts. I just placed the panel on the yellow card base and I attached each die-cut heart on the matching window. Next, I applied liquid glue at the back of the window panel, all over it, and I attached a large piece of acetate that I trimmed on one side. So here the window panel is complete. Next step was to add foam at the back of this window panel to create dimension and make room for the shaker accessories. And when I make a shaker card that has non-traditional shapes, I like to use foam strips. These are very easy to use and to bend to follow any shape. So before sticking each strip, I removed the backing paper to bend them more easily. And then I attached them all around the windows following the heart shapes. Thank you. So here we have foam all around the windows. Off screen, I added more foam along the long and short sides and between the hearts as well. And then I added powder on the inside edges of the foam around the hearts. Doing this step really helps to prevent the sequins or the beads from sticking to the foam strips. So, powder everywhere. Next, I cleaned up the excess with a microfiber cloth. And then I poured this rainbow mix by Spellbinders inside each heart window. I removed all the backing papers, and with the powder I applied before, the foam around the hearts was less sticky, so I just added a little bit of liquid glue on those spots. And then I placed the card base on top to finally close and complete my shaker panel. I pressed firmly on the paper to connect all the foam strips with the card base, and voila! I set my panel aside and moved on to the coloring. As always, I stamped my images using an alcohol marker friendly black ink, and I cut them using the coordinating dies, and I colored everything using my alcohol markers, many birds, branches, and cute bird houses. So once I was done with the coloring, I attached the images on the panel using foam squares mostly, as well as a little bit of liquid glue at some places. I attached a birdhouse in the middle of each heart window, and then added the branches and birds all around them to create a cute and fun little scene. When everything was attached, I white heat embossed a banner with my sentiment inside of it on vellum, and I stuck this banner using two tiny dots of liquid glue. And finally, to bring a touch of shine and to fill some empty spaces, I glued some clear droplets. And that's it, we have a sweet little scene with those lovely birds. So after the tropical birds last week, and those cute canaries today, can you guess which type of birds I will make next time? Thank you so much for watching, and see you next week with a new Sunny Studio card. Have a very nice day! Bye!